yokes of iron were going to be on your neck until, keyword, until you have been destroyed. So right. You ain't got a yoke of iron on your neck no more. What does that mean? That means that you have been what? Destroyed. The 12 tribes are the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans
right. Today.
We are the 12 tribes of Israel.
That's right.
Hispanics. And Native Americans.
All of us together.
All of us together.
All us melanated people.
All of us melanated people. Yeah, so look, okay. What has happened, we've been through several different captivities.
Right.
This ain't our first captivity.
It mixes and all that.
We mixed up. We got mixed up. That's why when you look at them, they look dip. Get that in Hosea real quick.
Seven.
For Ephraim. That's why when you look at them.
Seven. Look at them as who?
The Hispanics, okay, or the natives.
The other.
Because when we look at each other, we got some of the same similar features.
Yeah,
both
yeah,
y'all
yeah.
got dreads, but y'all got the same broad nose,
yeah,
same
yeah.
broad lips. You see
and
what
no
I'm
matter
saying?
Where you go, I'm learning this, right? I go to different states all around, and I be seeing people that look like my family, look
yes,
like somebody
because
I know.
We have the same features.
Everywhere we go, I'm a nose.
But in their captivities, they've been mixed around too, and their genes have caused their features to change. All right, you got that?
The book of Hosea, chapter 7, verse 8.
Come on.
Ephraim, he has mixed himself among the people.
So Ephraim is your Puerto Ricans today. Puerto Rican is not their nationality.
Oh, you was pointing out
here. Yeah, pointing out here. Yeah. When you look on the bottom of that flyer you got, it got the 12 tribes and who they are today. So Ephraim is the Puerto Ricans today. Puerto Rican is not a nationality. Puerto Rican means rich port.
Right.
That's what it means. But why? Because the place that during that time, that sea area was considered rich. You had a lot of diamonds, you had emeralds and all that different stuff amongst the sand and the waters. So that became known as Puerto Rican, meaning the rich port. But they're not Puerto Ricans. Their nationality is Ephraim. We got the same father. We all come from Jacob. That's why we are the children of Israel.
That's right.
Jacob had 12 sons. That list that you're looking right there are Jacob's 12 sons, right? Each one of those tribes have went into captivity and have been mixed around. Read that again.
Ephraim, he has mixed himself among the people.
It says that Ephraim in his captivity, they have mixed themselves among the people. Read.
Ephraim is a cake not turned.
It says Ephraim is a cake not turned. If you're baking a cake, right? Everybody done seen some bacon. You bake this. You done bake some cake now. So look, it says Ephraim is a cake not turned. When you first mix the batter of a cake, this is a parable. When you mix the batter for a cake and you dump it in the thing for it to start to form, if you don't turn the cake over, what happens? If you let one side continue to burn, what happens? It burns. So that top part is going to burn. What about the bottom part? It stayed the same. So it said Ephraim what?
Ephraim is a cake not turned.
So if you let the top part burn, when you take that cake out and flip it over, it still look like the batter. It's still white. It doesn't have the texture that the top part of the cake has. It says Ephraim is a cake not turned. Come on.
Strangers have devoured his strength.
It says strangers have devoured their strength. Why? Because the other nations outside of us are considered strangers. Your so-called white man, a stranger. Your so-called East Indians that run these stores, strangers. Chinese, strangers. All these other nations are heathen nations according to God. We are the righteous seed.
Right.
But they have stolen our inheritance and made us the lowest in society. Now, when it comes to the slave trade and how we got here, go to Deuteronomy chapter 7 and chapter 28, verse 15. Because once we were brought out of Egypt together, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, the nation of Israel as a whole at that time, Moses went up on the mountain, and God gave him commandments, laws, statutes that the children of Israel were to abide by, to keep. All right, so there were curses, there were blessings that we would get for keeping the commandments, and there were curses that we would receive if we did not keep the commandments. So read verse 15 real quick. Listen.
And people view that crazily, but that's just self-explanatory.
Yes, it's real
easy. It's like a mistake.
Yeah.
God designed mistakes for us to learn from, right? And people think mistakes are bad.
It's a punishment.
But it's not.
It's a punishment.
It's really not.
If your children
it's something to teach you. It's like a rod.
You whoop that honey.
There you go.
What you do then?
It's something to get you straight.
I just put them in the corner.
Okay, well, God did more than put us in a corner. All
right.
God put us in captivity. He put us in slavery. But listen, it's going to be clear. Just listen, read.
But it shall come to pass.
He said, Moses is talking to the children of Israel, but this is going to come to pass. Come on.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
If you choose not to listen to God and keep these commandments, come on.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
Come on.
And his statutes.
Read on.
Which I command thee this day.
Read.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So he said, if y'all don't do these curses, if y'all don't do what God is telling y'all to do according to righteousness, and you want to inherit the whole earth, you're going to be ruler of the earth. But if you destroy, but if you turn your back on these commandments, all these curses are going to come upon you. Now we're going to look at some curses. Jump to verse 32.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 32.
Look at your flyers. Look at the front part of your flyers. Come on.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Who did that happen to? Name another people on the earth whose sons and daughters were given to another people.
Nobody but us, and I've been doing that for years.
You said who? You Kunta. You Kunta.
Yeah, that's our man.
You is Kunta. You're that Kunta, all right? Read it again.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
So our spirit bear witness with the curses of this Bible that we are the children of God. That's how we know. Because this has not happened to nobody else on the planet. Read it again.
Ain't nobody else.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Read on.
And thine eyes shall look.
Your eyes are going to look and see your children being taken away from you. Come on.
And fail with longing for them all the day long.
You're going to see your children being taken away from you, and you can't do nothing about it. When they took away Kizzy's children, when they took away Kizzy on Roots, what could he do about it? Nothing. When they took the sister's children away from her on 12 Years a Slave, what could she do about it? Nothing. When DSS come to our houses right now, kicking our door for something, for some crazy reason, and take your children today, what can you do about it? Nothing. Why? The Bible's, read on. We're going to see why. Read on.
And there shall be no might in thy hand.
You ain't going to have no power in your hand, no military might, no economic might.
Right.
No, you have no power in your hand to get your children back. Why? Because God took the power that he gave us. He took that power because we broke the laws. Read on.
The fruit of thy land.
It said the fruit of your land, when we were in slavery, look on the flyer. Look at the flyer telling you. Look on the flyer. It says the fruit of your land. Come on.
And they and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
What I'm showing you is your people in them cotton fields. Your people in them cotton fields on that flyer.
Okay.
You see that? It says the fruit of your the fruit of the land.
Cotton fields
and
right now. You can ride by the steel seat.
But listen, it's more modernized now. You know what your cotton fields are today? Your barbershop.
Bring it
your
up.
Hair salon. Piggly Wiggly. Bilo. Whatever job you got today, is your cotton field.
Even if you are an entrepreneur.
Even if you're an entrepreneur, you still in the cotton field. Why? Because at the end of the year, what you got to do?
Teach.
Why? You don't know them people, what they did for you.
Bring it out.
You're in captivity, bro. You're in captivity. Jump to verse 45. Come on.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 45.
Read.
Moreover, all these curses shall come upon thee and shall pursue thee and overtake thee till thou be destroyed.
Until you are, it says, no matter where you go, these curses are going to come upon you, overtake you, and pursue you until you be destroyed. You can run anywhere you want. You run to China, in China, you still a nigga. You run to goddamn Africa, in Africa, you still a nigga. You go to Brazil, no matter where you go on this earth, you still a nigga.
Bring it out.
That song Jay-Z's put out, still nigga. Read.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Because we don't want to listen to God. God says, I have a dress code for you. Wear fringes on your clothes, dress like royalty, be the kings and priests that I told you to be, and I will put you above all nations on the earth. What
how
we say?
Give me one of them. What we
got a whole line. We got our stores. We got sisters that make these things. We got all kinds, bro. You just gotta follow the information on that fly.
Follow
you want to get fly?
Drip,
you want to get back
like
in your royal
drip.
In your royal
that's
garment? You can't get it. But God says, no matter where you go, these curses are gonna follow you. Read.
To keep his commandments and his statute which he commanded thee.
Come on, read.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
So, listen, this is how we know. God said that what he said about it?
They shall be upon thee for a sign.
How do I know that this is Oakland Plaza?
Bring it out.
What that sign say? The sign said Oakland Plaza. God says, and these curses are going to be upon you for a sign. Meaning you're going to be able to look at a specific group of people in the world, and you're going to know that these are the children of God because of the curses that they're suffering in the Bible. Right. Nobody else can fit that. Right. Nobody else can use this as a sign to say that they're the children of Israel except blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. That's the right. sign that we are the children of God is the curses of Deuteronomy.
Let me ask you the next question. Children is like, did we come from Hebrew? Like,
yes.
What do you call it?
We come from. You see, we come from Israel.
Israel.
We
that's
come from Jerusalem. But see, our people can't fathom how in the hell we get from Jerusalem. Why we think we Africa, but we in America? If you stay right here long enough, you're going to find the whole story out why we stuck right here in Oakland Avenue in captivity in 2020 if you stay right here long enough.
Right.
But let me, I'm going to show you. Read.
How long?
It ain't gonna take that long. It ain't gonna take that long. Hey, you know what? How long have we been in? You've been in captivity over 400 years.
You know.
Guess what? That's a long ass time. Now, if it took you 3 hours to learn how to take over the world, would it be worth it?
It'd be damn sure worth it.
So don't worry about how much time, brother. Just stay right there.
I'm gonna tell you. Well, you're good now.
Upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
Uh-huh.
And upon thy seed forever.
She said these curses gonna be upon you forever. Read.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God.
Because we didn't want to serve God, read.
With joyfulness.
With joyfulness. We didn't want to be happy. It's the Sabbath day. Today is the Lord's Sabbath.
Right.
When we
they lied to us, bro, and told us it's tomorrow.
It's not tomorrow. Today is the Lord's Sabbath. That's why we out here doing the work. All week long we work, we study, just to come out here and teach our people.
That's right.
Right. With joyfulness and with gladness for the abundance of all things.
Why? Because God gave us everything. He gave us the whole dang old world. He put the world in our hands and said, look, you are the gods of this earth. Follow these laws and go rule the world.
Right.
Well, there were other men and women amongst us. But you know what we say? Hold on, God. Look, they're having a good old time over there, though. I want to go try some of that crap that they're doing. And we turned our back on righteousness. But let's get into it. Read.
Therefore shall thou serve thine enemy.
God said, because you turned your back on my righteous laws, you didn't want to be God. You didn't want to be a princess.
Right.
Now what? Therefore,
thou shalt serve thy enemies.
So therefore, for you doing that, you're going to serve your enemies. Come on.
Which the Lord shall sin against thee.
Which the Lord God of heaven and earth is going to send against you. Send against you. Did it say send your friend against you?
Serve thine enemies.
Uh-huh.
Which the Lord shall sin against thee.
Come on.
In hunger.
In hunger. When you want food, where you go to? Your enemies down there to the store right here.
Yes,
right in the corner. Hey, you know what? You say, no, I go to North Food Fish Market. That's owned by a black man. Yeah, but guess what? He get his fish from somebody that owned the fish market.
That's right.
Guess what? He does not own that building.
He don't. He
at the end of the year, guess what he gotta do?
Pay taxes.
Why he gotta pay taxes over here? Come on, read.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness, when you want clothes, where you gotta go? To your enemies. Come on.
And in want of all things.
And anything you want, you must serve your enemies. For a death certificate, for a birth certificate, for a toothpaste, for toothbrush, for toilet paper. You don't get that from your brothers or your sisters. Who you get that from? The so-called white man and Elam, your other enemy. They've all had us in captivity. They've all raped, robbed, and murdered our people.
Right.
They all continue to use our communities to build their wealth and keep us on the bottom. They are exploiting our dollars today. Read.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Look on your flyers and look at the yoke of iron. Tell me who else fits this curse. Tell me who else had a yoke of iron put on their neck. Read.
Until he hath destroyed thee.
These yokes of iron were going to be on your neck until, keyword, until you have been destroyed. So you ain't got a yoke of iron on your neck no more. What does that mean? That means that you have been what? Destroyed. Now, I don't need to take chains and put on your neck. Now, I don't need to take chains and put on your ankles when I have a chain on your mind. You don't know that you're the children of Israel. You don't know that you have a God. You don't know that the God of heaven and earth is your God and only your God. You only know the information that I pumped into your people from year after year after year for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. I failed you exactly what I want you to know. Now I can let you go freely because you have no idea who you are. You have no idea that you are the God of the earth.
Right.
You have no idea that this earth belongs to you and your people. So you serve in captivity over and over and over. When you have children, you teach them to serve in captivity, to obey this white man who has put you in captivity. And the cycle continues over and over and over. But guess what? We're here today to break these generational curses. We're here today because the God of heaven and earth has raised these prophets up to come and teach our people right here in Oakland Avenue in Florence, South Carolina.
That's right.
That is why we're here. Read.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth.
It says God is going to bring this nation against you from far, from the end of the earth. Read.
As swift as the eagle flies.
Uh-oh, he gave you a sign. What you got on your collar right there, brother? As swift as the eagle flying.
Bring it out.
Look at your pendle right there. Look at that. As swift as the eagle flying. You're wearing the eagle. The eagle was Rome. The eagle were Greeks.
Bring it
the
out.
The eagle today is America.
That's right.
Look on your dollar bill. Look on your they show you who they are. They put it in your face. And you know what? We can't figure it out because what? We have been destroyed. We have been destroyed. It says, as swift as the eagle flies, come on.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
A nation whose tongue you ain't gonna understand. Look at that dollar bill. You see it? It got 13 arrows on it. The eagle is holding 13 arrows in each hand. Now, I want you to go do some research and look up the 13th Amendment. Tell me what that say. Read.
A nation of fierce countenance.
Uh-huh.
Which shall not regard the person of the old.
He say, this man ain't gonna regard the person of the old. He ain't gonna have no respect for the person of the old. Come on.
Nor show favor to the young.
He ain't gonna show favor to the young. He don't care what, how old you are, how young you are. We're bringing you to captivity to serve because you broke God's commandments. Read.
And he shall eat the fruit of the cattle.
He gonna eat the fruit of the cattle, come on.
And the fruit of thy land.
And the fruit of your land, because you slaved in these cotton fields. You slaved in these tobacco fields. You slaved on these jobs that we work. We slave on these jobs to provide for our families.
Right.
But they take the benefit. We eat none of the benefits. Read.
Until thou be destroyed.
Until you are destroyed.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.